Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Kelvin here. On September 27, Binance announced that they won't be allowing users in Singapore to deposit fiat, do spot trading, purchase of crypto through fiat and liquid swap. I'm sure right now, Singapore users be like, walao eh, sians. So, in this video, I will tell you what will happen, what you need to do, then I will also show you what's a good Binance alternative to buy your favorite cryptos. But before I start, I would greatly appreciate it if you can help to tap the like button, because it would help out the channel a lot. In return, I will show you a cute blue bird. Alright, let's start right now. First thing first, this ban is not instant. It will only come into effect 1 month later on October 26, 12 noon. How nice of Binance to give us time to withdraw. It's like when you are young, your mom tells you to stop playing computer games, but you don't want to. So she starts counting down. 3, 2, 1. So after this ban, what can you still use? From what I understand here, bank deposits and trading will no longer be available. That means crypto deposit and withdrawal and Binance Earn will still be available for now. This was also confirmed by the customer support. So here's what you need to do by October 26. First, withdraw all your crypto. Even though Binance hasn't banned crypto withdrawal, I would suggest transferring your crypto to somewhere else. It has always been my advice all along. After you buy your crypto, don't just leave it sitting there like a lazy bum bum. If you want to earn extra interest on your cryptos, transfer it to a high interest crypto platform like Holdenot and Celsius, where you can earn like 7% on your Bitcoin and Ethereum. But the downside is the platform may get hacked and you will lose all your cryptos. If you are scared that your cryptos will get stolen, you can transfer it to a cold storage like Ledger. I have a tutorial if you want to know how to use it. Second, BEF. Personally, I've staked a bit of Ethereum in Binance Earn as BEF. But only Binance and OKEx supports BEF, so I'm planning to convert BEF back to Ethereum to withdraw instead. However, as you can see here, BEF-Ethereum pair has dropped quite a bit. When converting, I'll be losing about 6%. But for PN, I guess no choice. Third, convert your DAS. If you go to Fiat and Spot Wallet, you might see that you have some cryptos in very small amounts. That is called DAS. Even though they are very little, like 1 cent, 2 cents, but if you combine them all together, you might be able to buy one extra Taifan. So go to the top, click convert small balance to BNB or Binance Coin. But I wouldn't suggest you to keep it as BNB because it's tied closely to Binance. If Binance touch wood GG one day, the value of this coin will go 18 levels underground. You can probably convert it to some better coins like Bitcoin or even Dogecoin if you want to YOLO. Okay, so here's the big question. There's exchange everywhere. Which exchange should we use next? Don't worry, I went and compared all the exchanges to find out which are the best ones, so you don't have to. Here are my criteria for choosing the crypto exchange. First, it must allow you to buy the top 3 cryptos, Bitcoin, Ethereum and Cardano. This means that a few exchanges are out already. Binance SG, Gemini and Luno doesn't support Cardano, so not in this list. Second, they must be among the largest and most reputable exchanges in the world, so they won't suddenly close shop and run away with your cryptos into the sunset. Because of this, I've also excluded KuCoin, because in 2020, KuCoin got into trouble with Singapore due to some legal issues. So here's the list. I have Coinbase, CoinHako, Crypto.com and a few more. Some of the stuff I'll be comparing are trading fees, number of supported cryptos, whether it supports HGD or not, what are the funding methods, and a few more stuff. A quick disclaimer, I have tried my best to find the information here, but there may be some inaccuracies in the list, yeah? If you find anything wrong, just let me know down in the comments below. Anyway, let's take a look at the trading fees first. You will notice that some exchanges have a fee range. That's because the higher you trade, the lower the fees will be. For example, in Kraken, if you trade $0 to $50,000 in 30 days, Maker is 0.16%, Taker is 0.26%. But if you are some rich Saudi prince who trades $10 million every month, your fees will be lower. So here's the result. CoinHako has the worst fee at 0.8%. For the exchanges with the best fees, Crypto.com has 0% fee, FTS is only 0.07%, OKEx at 0.1%. Next, number of coins. Independent Reserve and Tokenized Exchange has the least number of coins, while Poppy and OKEx has a few hundred coins. Now, this may or may not matter to you. If you are an ape from Wall Street Bets, you might like those weird coins like Elon. So that means the more coins, the better for you. But for normal people who only needs a few coins like Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano, Solana, then this comparison doesn't really matter. Next, does the exchange supports HGD or not? Coinbase supports HGD, but it only allows you to fund via credit card. The thing is, whenever you buy via credit card, that's usually a very high fee. Because of this, I wouldn't consider using Coinbase. Next, Kraken doesn't support SGD, so you will need to deposit USD in order to buy your cryptos. All the rest supports SGD, so that's good. Next comparison, funding methods. Okay, for all of the exchanges, you can always fund via crypto transfer. For example, you can buy Bitcoin in Gemini, then send to any of the exchanges here, then convert to the crypto that you want to buy. But this is an extra step. Ain't nobody got time for that. So I'll be comparing what are the other ways you can fund the exchanges. For most of the exchanges, you can do your normal bank transfer and SFERS. But I want to point out a few things. First, for Kraken, there's a godlike $10 fee for every deposit. Because of that, personally, I wouldn't consider using Kraken. Next, for Huobi and OKEx, they support peer-to-peer. If you don't know what's peer-to-peer, think of it like a carousel, where you can directly buy and sell cryptos with another user. The good thing with peer-to-peer is that sometimes you can get a better rate than the market rate, and usually the transaction is quite fast. But the downside is that if you are not careful, you anyhow choose the user, you may get scammed and lose your money. Next, BTC conversion rate. Here, I am comparing how much fiat I will need to convert to Bitcoin. The lower, the better, because it means I get to buy my cryptos at a good exchange rate. Check this out, there's two different currencies, USD for some exchanges and SGD for some exchanges. For most of the exchanges, the exchange rates are mostly the same, with some small difference of a few $10. But one thing that stands out is Crypto.com's exchange rate. If you compare it to CoinHako's SGD exchange rate, you will see that Crypto.com needs additional 600 plus to convert to one Bitcoin. This means even though Crypto.com doesn't have any trading fees, the exchange rate is slightly bad compared to CoinHako. So you'll be getting slightly lesser cryptos if you were to use Crypto.com to buy your cryptos. Next, MAS exemption list. So Binance was banned because it wasn't in the MAS exemption list, and it is the number one crypto exchange out there, followed by Coinbase, FTX, Huobi, Kraken. Check this out, I wasn't able to find FTX, Huobi, and Kraken in the MAS exemption list. Not too sure why the big exchanges always have the habit of not applying for license. If there's a small chance that MAS were to ban the next few exchanges, it may be this few. Personally, I feel that this is just a small issue because you will know when a ban is coming. So even though these exchanges are not in MAS exemption list, they are still safe to use for now. But if you don't want to keep moving here and there, then you will need to choose the exchanges that are in the MAS exemption list. Lastly, there are some things to take note. First, Coinbase doesn't support SGD bank transfer. The only way to buy your cryptos is to fund via credit card. For CoinHako, some of the cryptos doesn't support transfers. For example, you can't transfer Cardano in, and you cannot also send it out. So if you buy Cardano, you'll be stuck in CoinHako. For Crypto.com, you can only buy a few cryptos with SGD, like BTC, ETH, BCH, LTC, and so on. If you want to buy Dogecoin, you will first need to buy LTC, then convert LTC into Dogecoin. So there will be an extra step, meaning that you will lose more money on the exchange rate. Next, for FTS, you can withdraw your money. Can, no problem. But if you withdraw lesser than $10,000, there's a $75 fee, which is quite expensive. But this is not a big issue, because if you want to paper hands and sell your cryptos, you can always transfer your cryptos elsewhere to sell. Finally, for Independent Reserve, it only has desktop version. So if you use Independent Reserve, you will always have to use their website to buy your cryptos. But again, small issue. So out of so many exchanges, which will I choose? Here are my choices. I prefer FTX, Huobi, and OKEx. The reason I chose these exchanges is because I want an exchange that has good exchange rate, low trading fees, and supports as many cryptos as possible. The MAS exemption list doesn't bother me because I like to live on the edge. Just kidding. Worst case, if a ban comes, I can always use another crypto exchange. By the way, if you need referral codes to any of these crypto exchanges, you can find them in the description down below. Anyway, that's all for this video. Hopefully, you find it useful. Which crypto exchange are you moving to? Let me know down below. Like, share, and subscribe, as I'll be posting new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.